As well as elevation data, we can also obtain hydrological data from the internet to further improve our map. On your internet browser, visit the HydroSheds website. There is a link in the video description. This website contains river, lake, and basin data that is available to download for free. You can download data by region or for the entire globe. To download the data, scroll down to Shapefiles. As you can see, for most of the Middle East, you will need the Europe dataset, but for North African countries, you will need the Africa dataset. So, next to Africa or Europe, click download, and then download again. Save this file in the Geospatial folder of your GIS folder, or move it here when it finishes downloading from your downloads folder. Once your download has completed, it will need to be unzipped. So find it in your Geospatial folder, right-click it, and go to 7-zip, extract here. You will see a new folder with Hydro Rivers data. In QGIS, add this shapefile to your map using the Data Source Manager. Don't forget to click on Vector. And don't forget to look in the Hydro Rivers folder. Depending on where it has been added, drag it near the top of your map. We could make all of these rivers look the same. But it would be better to show their relative size. So right-click the river's shapefile and go to Properties. Click on the Symbology tab and change Single Symbol to Graduated. Change Value to Upland Square Kilometers. This is a column in the shapefile that gives the size of the catchment area upstream in square kilometers. Click on Symbol and change Width to 0.3 millimeters and click OK. And then change the color ramp to a suitable blue option. And then click Classify. You will see the larger the river, the darker the shade of blue. Click Apply and then OK. Don't forget to save your work. Have a go at creating a topographical map of your area of interest using this data.